Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to fix headphone problems on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. I'll be covering methods that could help fix a variety of headphone problems, such as sound or connection issues. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. The best place to start to fix headphone problems is the connection of the device. I'd recommend checking the connection and, if you can, try another port on your device. If your headphones use USB, try as many ports as you can on your PC. If you have a desktop, there should be plenty of ports on the back to try. If your headphones use the 3.5mm connector, make sure it is connected to the headphone port and not the microphone port. Whichever port you use, check that the connections aren't broken and that they are fully inserted into the port. The next thing to do is to try your headphones on another device if you can, such as a different PC or your phone. This will help rule out that the issue is with your headphones. If your headphones don't work on a separate device, it's likely that there is physical damage. If your headphones work normally on your other device, then the problem is likely caused by something within Windows, so that's what we'll focus on next. Within Windows, we will first check that our headphones are enabled or allowed. I'll show you two different ways to do this. First, head to the main settings page. You can get there a number of ways, but we'll be searching for it in the search bar. In the settings, go to the system settings from the options on the left, although you should be already in here by default. In the system settings, click on the option called sound. Within the sound settings, find the section called output. It should be right at the top. Under here, it should say something like choose where to play sound. Below this, you should see the list of headphones or sound output devices connected to your PC. If you have multiple, select the one you want to use by checking the box to the left of its name. If you don't see your device here, scroll down and click on All Sound Devices. Now find your device from the Output section, click on it, and then choose Allow on the next page. It should now appear back in the Output section of the main Sound Settings page. The second way to do this is if you click on More Sound Settings, which is in the main Sound Settings page that we were just on. In the new window, first go to the Playback tab. You should see all of the headphones, speakers, and other output devices in here. If you don't see your device in here, right-click on an option and choose Show Disabled and Show Disconnected Devices. To enable your headphones in here, right-click on them and then click on Enable. You can set it as the default sound output device in here too, with the button at the bottom of the window. Next, we'll try re-enabling the device, updating drivers, and then reinstalling the device. To do this, search for Device Manager in the search bar and open it. Within here, look for the section called Audio Inputs and Outputs, and expand it by double-clicking it. Now double-click on your headphones if you see them. If you don't see them, try looking in the Sound, Video and Game Controller section or the Bluetooth section. In the new window that opens, go to the Driver tab. First, select Disable in here, and then wait a few moments, and then select Enable. Try your headphones again now. Next, click on Update Driver, and then the Automatic option. If there are already the correct drivers installed, you can close this box. The third thing to try in here is to choose Uninstall Device, and then Uninstall. Now go to where it says Action at the top, and select Scan for Hardware Changes. Try your headphones once again now to see if this helped. If your headphones don't appear back in here, unplug them from your PC and reconnect them. Next, a simple system restart could help if you haven't done this already. A restart could help refresh a lot of the settings on your PC, and it could help fix the problem. It's up to you if you want to try this now or at the end of the video, but if you do restart now, when you return to the video, we'll have a few more solutions to try. The next method is to try running the Troubleshooter to see if Windows can find any possible problems with sound or our headphones. To do this, go to the main settings page by searching for it, and then in the settings, click on System from the options on the left side, but again you should be in here by default. In the system settings, click on Troubleshoot, and then on the next page, choose Other Troubleshooters. Now click on Run next to the Playing Audio Troubleshooter, and when you're asked to choose a device, click on your headphones. Wait and see if Windows can fix the problem. Next, think back to when the issue started appearing. There is a chance that a software change or hardware change caused the problem. This could be some new audio software or a new component. If you are certain that one of these changes caused the problem, then you could revert them or research how this will have affected your device and what you can do to work around it. If your headphones don't work in certain apps but do in others, this would most likely indicate that the settings in the app itself aren't set up correctly for your headphones. Have a look in the sound or audio settings to see if you can set it to use your headphones. The final thing I'd recommend is to check your manufacturer's website for more information. For example, your headphones may need a certain setup process or drivers to work properly. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. As always, I will keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways to speed up your Windows PC. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.